Taylor held on to the too big sweater with shaking hands. The familiar red and gold of the Kansas City Chiefs stood out against the tears that were running down her cheeks. The crowd at Arrowhead Stadium was applauding, but she could only hear a faint hum as her eyes locked on Travis. For a moment, she forgot about his party. As a pop princess and a football star, their romance had been a whirlwind. Every camera flash had been on them. Taylor wanted something normal to do with other people besides walking the red carpet and going to award shows. Travis loved her, but their plans rarely worked together. He would be obsessed with the season for months, while Taylor went on tour around the world. Even though the times they had together were precious, Taylor could not get rid of the pain that came from feeling like ships passing in the night. Things were different this year, though. Taylor had cut back on her traveling because she wanted to spend more time with Travis. But the gap between them stayed the same, a silent wall. That being said, today was the Super Bowl. It was Travis's most important game, and Taylor had adjusted her whole life to be there. There was a promise in the air that she would be there. As time ran out, the score was tied, making for a very exciting game. Every time the game started, Taylor felt a knot in her stomach. Then, with only seconds left, Travis came out from among the players with the winning touchdown wrapped in his gloved hands. The crowd erupted, and Taylor could feel tears coming to her eyes. The win didn't set off the dam, though. When the clock hit zero, Travis didn't run to the middle of the field like he usually does to celebrate. She was a bright red light in the sea of Chiefs fans that he saw in the seats. He ran toward the tunnel and then disappeared for a moment before coming back with a microphone. There was silence in the stadium as Travis spoke. His voice was heavy with emotion. He looked for her face and said, "This one goes to the strongest woman I know. Taylor, you've been my rock this year, even though we lived far apart. You had faith in me even when I didn't. You deserve more than just cheers from the crowd." The whole crowd held its breath as he took a deep breath. He asked, "Taylor Allison Swift," his voice breaking, "will you marry me?" The crowd screamed, but Taylor didn't even notice. The answer was the jacket she was holding. The words, "Future Mrs. Kelce," were embroidered across the back of the jacket, making it stand out from other Chiefs' shirts. They came up with the idea one night when they were alone, and it was a sign of the future they both wanted. Taylor's face was wet with tears of relief and pure happiness. With a scream that could be heard all over the stadium, she nodded and held up her sweater. To the roar of the crowd, Taylor knew at that moment that she was no longer just a famous girlfriend. She would marry Travis Kelce, and their paths finally crossed for the first time. Taylor held the old copy of The Love Story in her shaking hands. The pages were full of stories about people who lived happily ever after. The crowd's cheers for the Chiefs' win were just a faraway hum compared to the storm that was building inside her. Travis, her hugely romantic boyfriend, walked through the opening with a big smile on his face and the Super Bowl MVP trophy in his hand. "There you are," he yelled, his voice tense with joy. "Didn't see you at the after party." Taylor faked a wet smile. "Needed some quiet time." Travis's smile broke. He knew that smile, the one that could hide a lot of different feelings. As he walked closer, he became less loud and more concerned than normal. "Hey, what's wrong?" Taylor's eyes got teary. "Travis, it's not you." "Yes, really. It's..." She made a vague motion toward the book. Travis raised an eyebrow. He grabbed the book and his eyes lit up when he saw it. "Love story? What do you think? Remember when we first started going out together? You said you didn't like country music because it had too many sad love songs." Travis's face turned into a small smile of shame. "Yeah, maybe I got a little carried away proving I wasn't some cowboy wannabe." "It hurt, Travis," Taylor told him, her voice breaking. "This book and this song were everything I ever wanted. A love story that yelled and screamed from the rooftops." Travis felt his heart sink. He'd been so focused on being tough and the strong athlete by her side that he had forgotten about the little things. His eyes were sincere as he knelt in front of her. "Hey, pay attention. Being with you is the best touchdown I've ever had. I may not have understood, but seeing this," he tapped the book, seeing how much it means to you, it makes me want to rewrite the whole playbook." He pulled out his phone, his fingers flying across the screen. A moment later, the familiar twang of a guitar filled the room. Taylor gasped as a live video call connected, revealing her best friend Blake Lively standing on a Nashville stage, a microphone clutched in her hand. "Hey there, lovebirds," Blake winked. "Seems Travis here needs some backup vocals." Travis smiled, and his eyes sparkled. He held the phone towards Taylor, a silent invitation. With a shaky breath, Taylor wiped her tears, a spark of hope igniting in her eyes. She took a deep breath and began to sing, her voice raw with emotion, weaving a duet with Blake that resonated with a love that refused to be quiet. As the last note faded, the room erupted in cheers. It wasn't the roar of a stadium, but the roar of a love story finally finding its voice. Tears streamed down Taylor's face, but this time they were tears of joy, a melody of a dream coming true, a testament to a love that dared to be loud, a love story finally sung for the whole world to hear. The roar of the crowd was deafening, a pulsating wave of energy that shook the very foundation of the stadium. But for Taylor Swift, perched high above the field in a private box, the only sound that mattered was the choked sob that escaped her lips. Tears, shimmering like scattered diamonds, traced paths down her cheeks as she watched Travis Kelce, her impossibly tall boyfriend, dominate the field. It wasn't the game, another nail-biting victory for the Kansas City Chiefs, that had her on the verge of a meltdown. It was the celebration after. Travis, known for his flamboyant touchdown celebrations, surprised everyone, including Taylor, by kneeling on the center of the field. But it wasn't a celebratory pose. He was digging in his cleats, searching for something beneath the manicured grass. The commentators buzzed with confusion. The crowd, sensing something momentous, fell silent. Then, with a triumphant flourish, Travis held aloft a small, velvet box. The stadium lights glinted off the polished surface, sending a shaft of blinding white straight to Taylor's eyes. For months, their relationship had been a whirlwind of stolen moments, red carpets, and dodging paparazzi. Taylor, a queen of narrative in her music, had craved a normalcy she hadn't experienced in years. She yearned for quiet mornings, shared meals that weren't rushed, and the simple joy of building a life together, not just a career-juggling romance. Travis, oblivious or maybe just afraid, had reveled in the spotlight, basking in the glow of their A-list coupledom. Taylor had dropped hints, strategically placed lyrics in her new album, even staged a casual picnic in their Nashville backyard that was promptly swarmed by drones. But Travis, a champion on the field, seemed to fumble the off-field play. Now, as the weight of his gesture settled in, Taylor's tears turned from grief to a joyous storm. He hadn't proposed, as many anticipated. The box held a simple house key, engraved with a single word, home. The roar of the crowd returned, a deafening wave of approval that rivaled the game-winning touchdown. Cameras zoomed in on Taylor, her face a radiant mask of happy tears. In that moment, under the unforgiving stadium lights, Travis had finally caught her deepest desire. He wasn't offering her a grand gesture, a life in his world, but a place beside him in a world they could build together, brick by quiet brick. Later, after the confetti had settled and the interviews were done, they stood on the quiet porch of a small, unassuming house on the outskirts of Kansas City. Holding hands, they watched the first rays of dawn paint the sky a hopeful pink. Taylor squeezed Travis' hand. "This," she whispered, her voice thick with emotion, "is the real touchdown." Travis, finally understanding, grinned, the joy in his eyes mirroring the sunrise. He knew, at last, the game had just begun.